Well, it's no secret the leaves are changing all over Colorado. Here's a picture of those changing maples in Trinidad sent to us here at News Channel 13. Viewer Ann Rasmussen, absolutely gorgeous shot there. And of course, we're actually running a contest right now. You can check out all the info on that at KRDO.com and also submit your pictures to our Facebook, and you might just win yourself some money. How's that sound? As for our current temperatures right now, fairly chilly into the higher elevations, looking at the mid-50s, 56 into Salida there, 66 here into Canyon City. Still hanging tight to the mid-70s out in eastern Colorado, but those temperatures are going to begin to taper down as some cooler air slips into the region. As for our sky scan right now, you can see that area of low pressure that has moved out of the area that brought all the storms yesterday, still dragging some pretty significant moisture through the region. And as that moisture meets up with the mountains, that's when you get that upsloping flow, that cooler air tries to, or that warm moist air, should I say, tries to condense and cool, and that's when you start getting the snowfall into the higher elevations and see the rain shower activity there as well. And as we showed you in first weather, quite a few advisories out for western Colorado right now, some freeze and frost advisories we'll keep you posted on as well. As for the skycast, here's how we anticipate the next few days are going to play out for us. Notice we are expecting a little bit of snowfall into those higher elevations, and as that moisture continues to move through the region, come Tuesday, or excuse me, tonight I should say, we're looking at pretty decent cloud cover throughout eastern Colorado. A few spotty showers are likely going to break over top of the mountains, so an isolated shower or two is expected tonight. Nothing like what we saw yesterday. As we hit your move into your morning commute tomorrow, we're looking at a relatively clear start to the day, but look what's cooking behind it. Pretty significant amounts of moisture just north of Grand Junction. That is going to continue to move in, and look how much purple we're seeing on the map. Again, that is indicating snow. That's right, snow, but we're looking at overnight lows into the 30s, into the higher elevations. So it's no guess there. That moisture will continue to stream across the region as we move into your Wednesday afternoon, throwing some pretty decent amounts of moisture throughout the springs here. So do keep that in mind. It's going to be kind of like what we saw yesterday. Not nearly the severity of storms, but still likely going to see some lightning out of these storms. I don't anticipate we're going to see much in the way of hail. Just periods of heavier rain tracking right across the region. That will continue to move to the northeast. Again, very similar to what we saw yesterday. So the northeastern corner of the state is going to get a nice little shot of moisture here over the next few hours. As for lows tonight, cooling to the 20s and 30s. Look at that, 28 degrees into Leadville, 34 into Salida. Here into the springs, we're looking at 42, 43 into Pueblo, and a few mid-40s into eastern Colorado. So feeling a bit chilly. Now with those low temperatures, do keep in mind, we do have a few watches and warnings. That frost advisory for the Alamosa region as we move a little bit further north. Again, just west of Salida, we do have a freeze watch. So if you do have plants out, still into the higher elevations, wouldn't hurt to throw a blanket over those tonight in the next few days. It's going to be a bit chilly. Now, as for tomorrow, still into the 70s out in eastern Colorado and only looking at the 60s into the foothills, with the 50s into the higher elevations, really struggling to reach that 60-degree mark into the mountains. Over the next 7 days, here's how things play out for us. Again, pretty decent shot of moisture moving through Wednesday, lingering into Thursday, but then, as we showed you again in first weather, that area of high pressure rebuilds over the region. That's going to usher in plenty of sunshine to go around. Overnight lows still going to be a bit chilly, though. Only struggling to reach the 40s for your overnight lows. Rain showers moving through the area again into the Pueblo region Wednesday and Thursday there, but moving out very quickly as Friday rolls around. So a nice weekend. That's the good news there. 70s as we move into the weekend and next week into the Canyon City region again. Looking at 30s though for your overnight lows for the next few nights, and definitely keep your eye to the sky here into the Teller County region. You might even get some nice snow pictures. That's right, snow pictures, because we're looking at overnight lows about 30 degrees for Wednesday night, Thursday night 32, and struggling, but finally warming up to about 35 degrees come Saturday evening. So not a bad weekend to follow, but we've definitely got some chilly air to usher in, I guess, over the next few days.
So in the mornings, a little frost on the pumpkin.
A little bit of frost on the pumpkin, yeah. Wouldn't hurt to throw a blanket over the plants or anything like that. So.
And I know our fall colors contest goes through the middle of October, but it seems like time is running out quickly if you want to snap some of those
definitely.
Photos.
Yeah, it's amazing once that frost sets in just how quick those leaves change and then fall off, and you can't get decent fall pictures if there's no leaves to shoot. So
get out there.
Get out there and enjoy it, yeah.
Now, if I get any pictures of Branna jumping in leaves, do you think I have a good shot of winning?
I think so, yeah. That would definitely be a good
one. I'll submit that.
As long as we put it in this week's or this next year's Christmas calendar, I think we'll be all right.
That'll put me over the top.
Yeah, okay. Exactly.
Well, another data breach.
I'm doing it.
All right, we'll see.
He's got my iPhone out.
All right. Find a pile of leaves for me to jump into.
All right, you got it.
All right, another data.